10:29. Preparing meal one. Three eggs. I'm gonna have some toast, and then I'm gonna have some piece of meat with that. In my mind, I was thinking, these eggs, it's gonna have a little bit of protein in, but it's something. But then I remember that there's needs to be, so I was thinking, okay, no, now we're talking. This is actually a solid meal, because there's at least more protein involved. I might have a minced meat sandwich, but I certainly do plan on having toast. Maybe egg, yeah, maybe a bit of scrambled eggs, a bit of minced meat, a bit of ketchup, and then that's me sorted. I'll show the minced meat that I'm using now. Literally just what I could find in the kitchen because of my financial situation. I'm getting things myself. I can get things myself. However, at this point in time, I don't deem it a financially sensible decision. That's what I would. Right. I'm gonna just carry on letting that minced meat defrost. I'm gonna fry my eggs, then get the toast ready. I'm actually gonna get the ketchup now. Why not? I know I'm gonna use it. And then, with that in mind, I'll have that meal and go to the gym sooner or later. Yeah. But anyway, on that note, I'll finish it now, and I'll play the next clip. In preparation to cook the minced meat and the eggs. I'm using this for the minced meat because it's a smaller portion, or it's a smaller amount, or so I thought, of a smaller volume of food. I thought, yeah, I'll just put it in the small one here. We'll see how that goes. So 10 sprays in that to cover the minced meat, and then 15 sprays to cover the whole pan for the eggs. I just had a thought about adding this. So I'm gonna get it just so that there's some more nutrients in the meal. This is, in my mind, now actually starting to turn into a solid meal. Yes, I thought about it off the top of my head, but in my mind I was thinking of saying, calling it an impulsive thought. I don't know if those words have derogatory connotations, but I don't need to call it that. I just had a thought off the top of my head. It's not... That's fine. I was making it seem like it wasn't okay to do that by using that word, I think. I'm not sure it's something that I'd have to think about, but anyway, yeah, I'm gonna add this in. I'm just gonna defrost it, and then yeah, that's gonna be the meal with some toast that I need to put in the toaster now. Right, a long while after, meal one is now ready to eat at 10:57 in the morning. The butter is now finished as well, so I'm gonna throw this away. And then we'll be using this one instead, if I'm ever having sandwiches like this in the future, which I might do, yeah. 3:11, meal two. This probably isn't the healthiest of meals that I could have, to be honest, and it is something that I need to work on, especially when I improve my financial health. That's why I'm eating like this. But as for this meal in particular, I thought of it in my mind, just off the top of my head. Not right now, but a few minutes ago, the idea just popped into my mind, and I didn't really think it through any further when I thought about it at that time, maybe less than half an hour ago. However, as I was just getting the meal together, I was thinking, well, I could have the slice of bread and the butter with the main, with some, not mayonnaise, with some of the bolognese that I had there. But I thought, nah, I don't want bolognese on my toast, because I want to have rice with the bolognese that I've got there. So this is what we've got. And also because I couldn't see any cheese or chicken or anything like that, which could have been at least a bit healthier than this extremely processed spread. How processed? Like, how is it processed? I don't know, but I'm just saying that with negative connotations is to try and protect myself from eating this sort of unhealthy food. I don't know what's in it. Of course it's here, but emulsifiers. I have no idea like
what I'm really putting in my system, and I'm saying that with negative connotations. It's really my best interest to learn more about the foods that I eat, and just food in general. Especially after improving my financial health, I'll be able to make much more sound decisions with my food in terms of what I eat after doing that. Anyway, I'm going to stop chewing and I'm going to carry on eating this meal now. Yeah.
Right. I've now felt the need to make a voiceover section to explain what's going on here. Very basically, I did not want to go on the phone to track how much rice I had left over from yesterday and how much of the bolognese mix that I had left over from yesterday. So I made a brief note, as you can see here, 310 grams of brown rice and 171 grams of the bolognese mix I had left over from having two portions of that, right, of rice and of the bolognese mix. So that's what we've got left over. Or that's what I've got left over, rather. And I'm probably going to finish off the bolognese mix today, to be honest, so that I can have a hot meal that's at least somewhat healthy, seeing as you've got the mixed veg there. For some reason, they cut out. I don't know why. Sometimes CapCut does this. Well, basically, from personal experience, almost all the time, excluding that one time, I had like a 45-minute take on one of the daily logs. However, yeah, anyway, that's what this is, this voiceover note's for. So, on that note, I'm done with the voiceover, and on to the next clip.
7 o'clock, bang on, dishing out meal three. I was thinking of having this with the rest of the bolognese mix that's there. I still am, however, I'm going to have a salami sandwich with that, because I've seen the salami in the fridge. Of course, there's the bread here, and I think that'd help me with having a more filling meal. Yeah. It was 171, but because of transfer, it's now 169, which I wouldn't have known if I didn't weigh it. I was thinking, well, I know how much is there exactly, but I knew how much was there, not exactly how much I would have been eating. So even though I knew how much is there, still a sensible decision to weigh, because you can get this 2 gram difference. Course, short term, that's not going to be a big deal, but just to make sure I have an accurate record of what I'm feeding myself, it's necessary, regardless of if I know exactly how much is in the containers. Never mind, I was looking at the clementine juice like it's salami. Salami, it wasn't actually salami. This is what I was seeing. I saw that. Didn't read the C, or the E, or the L, or the E, or the M. Put it back. Yeah. So, that's not happening. But, at least I still have something to eat. I was like, you know what, I'm going to do anyway. And I had this one. I have this burger sauce rather than this burger sauce here, because this one's smaller. That was it. That was the only reason I had. Yeah, this one was bigger than that one, so I'm gonna use that one instead. Anyway, at 10 past, or 11 past, I should say, 7 in the evening, I'm now gonna have this toaster start, along with that. It's been a while, so it's been a few minutes, so I'll probably reheat that again. But yeah, anyway, I'm gonna have the meal now. This meal now, bro. Rather, 28 past 11, later than usual, I'm having this because I'm feeling so hungry, and also I have stayed on. The laptop for longer than usual. Look at how tight my core is, man. It's so tight. And I'm certainly not forcing myself to not eat, because my stomach's feeling that tight. I'm gonna get some milk with this. I need to get a little bit of protein in there. I'm gonna use this one over this larger, the Boss cup, because I couldn't be bothered to get it, even though it's right there. It's literally right there. But I couldn't be bothered. I'm feeling that hungry. Actually, you know what? No. I am going to get it specifically to show to myself that I am in control. My hunger doesn't take control of my decisions. Not this one, and not these types of decisions, no. If I want something, I want to go get it. There you go. It won't be that difficult. Whilst I was doing all of that talking, I could have been getting it. However, I'm not going to make beat myself up about it. Or make myself feel down about it but in any way. Anyway, I'm going to do this now. I'm going to have to find the time again, but I'll say it. 11:30 p.m. bang on. I'm not making myself feel extremely hungry because I said, oh well, I'm not eating past 10 p.m. No, if I'm feeling extremely hungry, I'm eating. Anyway, that's it. That's the end of the video. Let me see what I get up to. Tomorrow's long. Log. Peace. I saw these in the fridge, and I was thinking, you know what? I'm gonna use these because my stomach was still feeling tight after having that. So that sandwich. So. Yeah, I've had 4 tablespoons of this, which I just opened, and this was half open. Well, this was open, and then it was half used. Didn't look moldy, so I was like, yeah, didn't look moldy, and it smelled fresh, so I was like, yeah, just so that I don't feel constipated, I'll have this. I was thinking of having it with some apples, but I tried testing some of them. They didn't feel fresh, like that one there. I bit into it off camera. Feel fresh. Tried pressing on this one, didn't feel as fresh as I'd like, especially here. So I was like, okay, well, I'm not gonna have that then. This one, same story, and that one certainly is. Oh, it's an orange. I thought it was an apple, but yeah, seeing as I thought it was an apple, same story. Okay. Anyway, I'm gonna have this, and this should be the last meal. I might actually stay up for quite a bit because of this. And I wanna make a discovery. I wanna note a discovery that I've made. I had a thought, maybe I should watch YouTube with this, or something along the lines of that, almost verbatim. And I was thinking, okay, because I'd be doing this, I'd be thinking this probably, maybe subconsciously, I'd associate YouTube with eating, meaning when I'd eat, I'd think of watching YouTube too, which I would have done if I didn't catch myself thinking this way. But what I was thinking about potentially unconsciously has now come to light, and now here we are. Yeah, I know not to do that. It's not healthy. Consuming YouTube, which could be extremely, extremely addictive and override any sort of dopamine sensors that we'd have left after doing it for so long. This is not healthy. So, yeah, I say that whilst this video is going to be up on exactly what I'm saying. It's extremely unhealthy. However, I'm not experiencing it as much because I'm the one making the videos rather than the one that's consuming so many videos. Yeah, I could say, well, you don't have to watch. Oh, come on, man. But yeah, instead of saying that, like how any person from the takeaway shops might, how like any drug dealers might, I'm instead going to say something else. If you do want to watch, that is on you. However, it absolutely is within our best interest to consume in a healthy way and to work through any unhealthy or negative patterns that we'd be doing with our consumption, whether it be through eating food or whether it be through the information that we consume, both offline and online. sorry.
Yeah.
On that note, I feel happy that I've made that discovery. However, this is going to be the end of the video. I want to see what the time is and then say anything else that I want to say, if I have anything else. Right. It's 11:43 p.m. and I'm now going to have this meal. But as for the personal responsibility thing, yeah, that might be true, but it'd be rather dishonest of me to say that. YouTube isn't addictive at all. Simply just sort of because I'm making the videos and I'm not the one consuming them. It's just not the case. And it absolutely is within our best interests to watch a healthy amount about things that we can use to help ourselves grow if we are going to come to this site and watch videos, rather than just saying, oh, well, it is the personal responsibility, and then just watching anything, any sort of unhealthy content or videos, sorry. Don't need to use those fancy words. Like videos of people getting murdered, like actually getting murdered, not movies, like actual murders, such as cartel murders, for example, or something like that. Murders in the retail store that I've seen online, on YouTube, in documentaries. It can be a really unhealthy place, and it is within our best interest to it is within our best interest to take care of and consciously pick what we watch. Otherwise, we could get that and go down a very unhealthy downward spiral. Not only with what we watch to begin with, but also in many other ways down the line. So I'm not going to give that personal responsibility argument only, but I will say to both myself and other people, if they are looking for advice, just be careful and be aware that there's some very, very, very dark things on this platform. That's it. With that in mind, it's within our best interest to watch to an extent where we, metaphorically speaking, we feel full and not go past that point, like how I would in the past, excluding yesterday when I couldn't even watch 2.5 minutes of a Healthy Gamer GG video, which I consciously picked after going scrolling through the videos made on that channel. I lasted two minutes 15 seconds watching that video. 2 minutes 15. That was when I felt full. It literally is like full. It literally is like food. So I'm going to describe it like that from now on. I felt full at 2 minutes and 15 seconds. That was it. That was me done. So I listened to my limits. I listened to my limits and I went off. It really is as simple as that. And the reason why I'm thinking of it like food is specifically because of the fact that just like how we consume information, we consume food as well. And that's where my mind was telling me to stop, just like how I'd know to stop after eating a certain amount. Anyway, that's a new way of thinking I've developed right here, right now, on YouTube consumption and just consumption in general. Consume healthy foods that allow us to grow and nourish our mind, and consume to the point that we feel full, not beyond that point. And also not below that point. We'll know when that comes. I think if we're starting to feel overstimulated from even reading books, that's the time to cut it off. That's the time when we're full. I'll think of that way from now on. I like that. And if I think I need to develop it, that way of thinking, and change it, so be it. But for now, that will do, because I'm going to use that as my guide. Literally treat it like food. And also, I could, now that I think about it as well, I could also treat like getting things done or productivity the same way. Don't undereat and don't overeat. It really is as simple as that. You think now that I've made this different way of thinking, you think I have a massive smile on my face? Nah, I certainly am not feeling unhappy about this new way of thinking that I've just made up on the spot. However, I'm feeling at peace. It's not that I don't care, that's not why I shrugged, but I'm feeling okay, thirsty, but okay, I'm feeling all right. Not extremely happy at face value, just not real life, and I'm not prepared to put an act on the camera. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's not even mine, because YouTube's not my platform. I didn't create this platform. Sure, I absolutely am making these videos, but I didn't create this platform. However, yeah, although I might not look very happy at first glance and on the surface, I certainly am at least feeling at peace deep down, and feeling happy deep down, at least potentially, from thinking this new way, because I can use this new way of thinking to help guide me, to help guide myself through all aspects of life. Cheersy lot. Hey. And self-hug for this new way of thinking. I can absolutely use that as a healthy guide for me from now on. Anyway, I am done, other than this one last note. I was going to the toilet less than an hour ago, and I was thinking that all of that sort of stuff, that comes first. Fulfilling basic survival needs. Warmth, food, water, shelter, clothing, etc. Hey, that rhymed. All of that comes first before looking to see my abs. Although I can see my abs, that absolutely does not matter first over my basic human needs to survive. It's a way I've thought of in the past, but now I've just reaffirmed it today. None of this matters if I'm not eating. None of the being able to see my abs and the low body fat percentage matters if it matters over eating in a healthy way, eating healthy foods, drinking a healthy amount of water, and eventually drinking filtered water, which at least might not have as many additives as tap water might, which could be destroying my body. Warmth, shelter, clothing. None of this, for example, the fact a lower body fat percentage means absolutely F all if I'm homeless. It means nothing. Absolutely nothing. I'd have much, much bigger fish to fry if I was homeless. So just on that example alone, I've reaffirmed my beliefs through thinking that way. It really doesn't matter. First, it being able to see my abs first over my basic survival needs. None of that low body fat percentage S matters if I don't have a home to stay in. If I don't have food to eat, let alone healthy food, none of that matters. Being able to see maps does not matter over that. It absolutely doesn't. But at least I understand that now. It wasn't that I didn't understand that in the past, it's just that I didn't make it very clear cut and concrete as much as I have now. It's something that I might have forgotten about. Anyway, I'm gonna finally eat this yogurt dessert now. I'm gonna try it out. If I think it's too warm, I'm gonna add one ice cube or so. Could be cooler. I think I'll add one ice cube so that it's not too thick, so that it's not too thin, but also so that it's cooler. On that note, I'll do that now and show that on camera. And then that will be me done, signing out. Cheers to living in a healthy world. Absolutely as possible. That was too many. I've got three ice cubes now. Just put that in my flask. Anyway, this is me signing out. Cheers to a much healthier future, people. It absolutely can be done bit by bit. day by day. It's me signing out. See you tomorrow. Let's see what I get up to tomorrow, the days after, and the days after. Cheers to living honestly, and cheers to making honest, truthful progress. Cheers. Anyway, I'm out. It's me signing out. Peace. On a side note, I feel grateful for breaking that 10 p.m. rule I made today, or otherwise I might not have found it out. I might not have made that way of thinking that I've made. Or I might not have made it as quickly or at this point in time. Alright, I'm gone. I'm actually gone this time. Peace. At 11:55 p.m. Anyway, bye.